This is the second night in a row Willington residents are gathering on the town green remembering 62-year-old Ted Demers. People telling me the horrible crime has really brought the small community together.
We know that a lot of people are sleeping much better now.
Willington and neighboring residents are no longer afraid of knowing Peter Manfredonia, who police say killed 62-year-old Ted Demers, and 23-year-old Nicholas Isley is behind bars. Their worst fear was not only knowing he was still on the loose, but possibly hearing about more victims.
It was just such a complete shock, and you know, I know a lot of people have been working really hard on so many fronts to really, you know, support the families.
Candles were circled around the town green, some bringing new ones, some lighting them, some just there to show their support. For those who knew him as family or a friend, it was even more personal.
Ted's a great guy. Him and my ex-husband actually were really good friends and, you know, willing to help each other, help a neighbor, help anybody who needed help.
The rain setting the vigil's mood, a solemn moment, yet a justified one.
It's a wonderful community in this eastern Connecticut with the small towns and everything. They support each other.
Demers' cousin, Amy Cavitos, was reminded of his artistry. He was a talented woodworker, creating one-of-a-kind pieces for families at flea markets.
He would have a naughty little giggle or whatever, but a snicker. But gardening, I mean, their garden's just beautiful and such an artisan, like a woodworker.
The tight-knit community can finally feel at peace, but now wonder why Demers, who many call the gentle soul, was targeted.
We're gonna miss him a lot.
Manfredonia is currently in Maryland awaiting extradition back to Connecticut, which could happen in the next week or so. State police telling us he could be facing state and federal charges. Reporting in Willington, Carmen Chow, Fox 61 News.